of all, I'm Lynn Ruth Miller, and I'm still alive, and I hope you are too, with all the wonderful reviews of the fabulous, exciting, marvelous, exhilarating shows in Brighton in the month of May. Today we're going to see a snippet of Rose Collis, who's giving us 30 years of her life condensed into 1 hour. My God, it would take me at least 3 months to give you 30 years of my life.
Hello, I'm Rose Collis. Now, you might know me better for being a biographer and a writer and the author of the new Encyclopedia of Brighton. But what you might not know is that I used to be a performer and a musician, and I still am. And this year, I'm unveiling my one-woman musical cabaret show called Trouser Wearing Characters.
Sister is busy learning to shave. Brother just loves his permanent wave. It's hard to tell them apart today.
I say it's a one-woman, but there'll be me and two vintage banjolalis, Alvin and Bud. And you'll see more about Bud later. The show draws on a lot of books that I've written or people I've written about in other forms, including Dougie Bing, who lived in Brighton, the wonderful effing lady Coral Brown, Nancy Spain, one of the great media stars of the 50s and 60s, and Colonel Sir Victor Barker, DSO, another notorious character in Brighton's history. It's bringing together pretty much everything I've done in the last sort of 20 or 30 years, so it's a bit of history, comedy, music, and songs. Some of them are vintage songs, and some of them sound like vintage songs, except I wrote them. So if you want to see some surprises and have some fun and learn something that perhaps you didn't know, come along and see my show. I'm doing 6 performances at the Marlborough Theatre, and the Brighton Fringe Festival is the show's world premiere.
Today, Vicki Nagel interviews Cliff Barnes, and he'll tell you all the exciting things that are happening at Caroline of Brunswick.
Here we are at the Caroline of Brunswick, pretty much the epicentre of comedy on the small scale in Brighton.
That last year, we signed up with Laughing Horse, who had the Temple and the Quadrant and the Hobgoblin as their venues. I went up to Laughing Horse and said, you know, we've got a nice venue here as well, if you want a fourth. And so, last year's Fringe, there's loads of shows on. This year we've got even more because we're established now properly as a Laughing Horse venue. So we've got a totally packed Fringe programme of about 100 shows, I think, 100 performances of nearly 30 different shows. We've got Helen Keen, the science comedian. She'll be doing a new show about, what's it called, Robot Woman of the Future.
She's a BBC radio regular, really, isn't she?
Yeah, she does Radio 4s. Who else we've got? We've got Meryl O'Rourke, who's a big name on the London scene. Her show, Bad Mother, she's actually bringing that around for the second time. It's now developed because last year it was all about how she had this, she's got this one young daughter, and it's about her being a bad mother, but also about her mother, and they all ended with, there's no way I'm having another kid. She's about to have another kid. She's going to be out to here in May. I had a dream when I was on holiday in Belgium last year or the year before, that this room went around in an L shape and had another 20 seats over there. And then I woke up and I thought, that can happen. That can actually happen.
Will you be watching them all?
I will, yeah. I won't be watching every performance of every one, but I will watch every show at least once.
Well, thank you very much for that. And we look forward to seeing a whole load of great comedy upstairs here at the Caroline of Brunswick.
Today, you are going to meet Luna Eva, who's going to give us insight into the madness that's sweeping the population. And you'll find that it's the mad people who are truly sane.
Hi, I'm Evo Luna. My show is called Luna's History of Madness. It's the history of madness in general, but more importantly, it's my own history of dealing with certain mental conditions. One in four of us are actually going to have mental health problems at some point, so it's an issue that's relevant for pretty much everybody. The show includes a lot of computer-generated animations, a lot of my photography. It's a very visual show, a bit like a presentation to some point, but it's more than just a presentation, more than just a talk. I will be doing a live demonstration of an electric shock machine that used to be used back in the day that you could buy over the counter, and talking quite a bit about strange remedies that used to be used for healing hysteria, for example, giving women hysterical paroxysms, which were basically orgasms in modern speak. Will be funny and entertaining, and everyone will go away feeling incredibly inspired, uplifted, and looking forward to the next day.
Today you're going to meet Maggie Gordon, a woman who's been trying to commit suicide, but she keeps getting interrupted. I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. See the show and then you can find out.
My name is Maggie Gordon-Walker. I'm in Cheer Up, It Might Never Happen. It's a dark, dark comedy about a woman who wants to commit suicide, which doesn't sound like an obvious subject for humour, but in this show, which is one you focus on something private and personal, with the outside world continually intruding in the shape of unwanted phone calls and things that have to be dealt with, insects in the room, won't go any further on that. So yeah, it's hopefully for people, it's a comment on how life is so busy, there's always the phone to be answered, always an email to be answered, that you can't take the time to focus on what's really important for you.
Today you're going to meet Sameena Zehra, who is going to tell you what it's like to have tea with a terrorist. I can imagine that there are no biscuits involved.
Hi, I'm Sameena Zehra, and my show is called Tea with Terrorists. And it's essentially that. It's a collection of stories about my life, straddling two very different cultures. I grew up in a very religious but liberal family. I argued a lot with mullahs. I planned the perfect murder. I've been stalked by a sheep in Coniston. And I ended up having tea with some terrorists in Kashmir. Not exactly with them, but kind of with them. I will tell you how I got there in the first place, because nobody sets out to have tea with terrorists, do they? Unless you're already a terrorist in a terrorist cell. In which case it would be slightly weird if you didn't have tea with the rest of the terrorists. And it would look suspicious. Anyway, come and see it. It'll be a great night. It's very good fun. There's lots of laughs and there's a story to it as well. And I think you'll enjoy it. And you'll regret it if you don't come.
Sexy camp cars. I hope you enjoyed today's show with a bit of madness, a bit of suicide, and tea with a terrorist, and a little bit of comedy on the side. I'll see you tomorrow if I'm still alive.
Never do good business when the sun goes down. Sweet sharp sound will be open in a while. Selling sugar and spice, all those naughty things nice, yeah.